observe my eyes carefully. And if you're looking at the screen, your left side, or which is my right eye, the eyeshadows are popping more and are darker than my left side. I use the same eyeshadows on both eyes and I use the same technique. But still, my right side is darker than my left side. How's that possible? The answer is in the eyeshadow base. Today I'm going to be showing you how you can change a complete eyeshadow look by just switching the base. So if you're ready, let's begin. I'm done with my brows and the only thing I've used on my eyelids is the Laura Mercier Illuminating Eye Cream and I used it on both the eyelids. Today I'm going to be using the Moonlight Crystal Gemstone Palette by Aether Beauty, which is a clean beauty brand and is available on Credo. But before that, I'm going to be priming my lids with a base. On my left side, I'm going to be using the P. Louise base in the shade Rumor 5. I'm going to be using a blending brush to evenly coat it and I'm not going to be setting it with any powder because I'm going to be using a lot of shimmer eyeshadows and they stick better when the base is tacky. So while this base is still tacky, I'm going to be using this beautiful deep turquoise shade right on top of it. And I'm saturating my entire lid with a flat shader brush. You can also use your finger if you prefer. That's looking good. On my right side, instead of using an eyeshadow base, I'm going with a gel liner. I'm going to be using the Inglot gel liner. Now, if you don't have a gel liner, you can also use a black eye pencil. All I'm going to be doing is just like I did with the eyeshadow base, I'm going to be saturating my entire lid with this. And over this, I'm going to be using the deep turquoise eyeshadow that I used on my left side. And I'm going to set my entire lid with it. And look at that difference. My right side is so much more deeper than my left side. The eyeshadow is popping so much more. I'm going to diffuse the edges and make it a little bit more softer so it's easier to blend out the transition shade. Now that we've completely saturated both the lids, you can clearly see a difference. You can see how my right side is popping so much more than my left side. Now, instead of using a gel liner as your base, you can also use the same color base as your eyeshadow. P. Louise has so many different options in terms of colors, and there's also a lot of drugstore options. I'm going to list a few in the description box below, so do check that out. Let's continue with the eye makeup. I'm going to be using this beautiful, shimmery, buttery, soft purple shade in the inner third of my lid. That looks beautiful. We'll also do the same on my right side. Because the turquoise is deeper on my right side, we already have a deep background, so the purple is also appearing deeper on my right side. For transition, I'm going to be using the Rimmel bronzer. With a blending brush, I'm going to blend it out at the crease. And I'm going to be doing the same on my right side as well. We don't have the gel liner above the crease, but still the transition is looking deeper on the right side as compared to the left side. And the reason for that is, if you remember, we had smudged out or softened the gel liner at the crease. We had diffused it so the blending becomes easier with the transition shade. Now that black gel liner is mixing with the transition and giving that deeper shade. And then I'm going to be using the bronzer to smoke it out in my lower lash line using a small definer brush. Next, I'm going to be using this beautiful sparkly shade in the inner corner to highlight it. And then I'm going to be using this beautiful charcoal shade, which has a maroon undertone. I'm going to smoke it out in the outer corner, creating a smoky liner. It's time to finish up, so I'm going to curl my lashes. And for mascara, I'm going to be using the Strength and Length Serum Infused Mascara. This is from Bare Minerals. And here's the completed look. I would love for you to try this at home and come back here and let me know how you liked it or loved it. And if you enjoyed this tutorial, please don't forget to thumbs up. And if you're new here, please consider subscribing. I post several times a week. And my social media links are listed down below in the description box in case you plan to follow me there. I love you guys so much, and I will see you soon with a brand new one. Bye, guys.